Hello everyone. Today our topic in virtual memory is page replacement. In the previous video, we discussed demand paging and the steps taken by the operating system when a page fault occurs. A quick revision for that. If the address generated by the CPU is a legal address, then the page table is checked for the valid invalid bit and the frame number. If the bit is valid, then we reference the physical memory as usual. We retrieve from the page table the frame number, which is then concatenated with the page offset to obtain the physical address. If the reference page is not in memory, the valid invalid bit is invalid, then a trap to the operating system occurs. The operating system determines the type of the trap, in this case, page fault. It saves the process state and look for a free frame and request a read operation to the backing store. The required page is then swapped in into this free frame and the page table entries are corrected. Here we store the frame number and the valid invalid bit is updated to valid. When the CPU is allocated to this process, the instruction is restarted, but now we have the required page in memory. Now the question is, what if we haven't a free frame in physical memory? Consider, for example, the following scenario, where we have in memory some pages for user 1 and user 2. For user 1, we have in memory logical page 0, logical page 1, and logical page 2. As you see here, we haven't free frames. Suppose now that user 1 is referencing page 3, and its valid invalid bit is invalid, which means that the page is not in memory. And in the same manner, user 2 reference logical page 1, again, it is not in memory, and we haven't free frames in physical memory to bring these pages from the backing store. At this point, the operating system has several options. It could terminate the user process. However, demand paging is the operating system's attempt to improve the computer system's utilization and the throughput. Users are not aware that their processes are running on a demand page system. Paging should be transparent to the user, so this option is not the best. The operating system could instead swap out the process, freeing all its frames and reducing the degree of multiprogramming. In this case, the frames occupied by this process will be free for other processes. In some cases, this solution is a good one, and we will discuss it later. Another solution is to put the process requesting more pages into a wait queue until some free frames become available. Here we will discuss the most common solution, which is page replacement. The main idea is to find some page in memory and swap that page out to disk, freeing up a frame that can be allocated to the process requesting it. So according to demand paging, we find the location of the desired page on the disk. Next, the operating system should find a free frame. If there is a free frame, we swap in the required page into this free frame as we discussed earlier. If there is no free frame, we use a page replacement algorithm to select a victim frame. The victim frame is swapped out into the disk and the page table for this process is updated accordingly. Next, the desired page is swapped in into the newly freed frame. And again, the page table for this process is updated to reflect this action. The frame number is stored in the frame field and the valid invalid bit is set to valid. After that, we can continue the user process from where the page fault occurred. You can note here that in step C, the victim page should be swapped out. We discussed in the previous chapter that we can use a dirty bit associated with each entry of the page table to indicate whether this page has been modified or not. If this page has not been modified, then its copies in the physical memory and in the packing store are the same and we do not need to swap it out. In this case, we can directly swap in the desired page overwriting the victim page. And this will improve the system performance since the swap takes an extra time. There are two major requirements to implement demand paging. We must develop a frame allocation algorithm and a page replacement algorithm. The purpose of a frame allocation algorithm is to determine the number of frames that should be allocated to each process. And the purpose of a page replacement algorithm is to find out how to select a page for replacement or which page should be selected as a victim page. The goal in selecting and tuning these algorithms is to generate the fewest number of page faults. Regarding the number of frames allocated to each process, if we allocate more frames to each process, then the number of page faults decreases. So it's better to assign to each process large number of frames in order to decrease the page fault rate. Later in this chapter, we'll discuss different strategies of allocating free frames to the processes competing for these frames. Algorithms are evaluated using a string of memory accesses known as a reference string. We can generate reference strings artificially by using a random number generator, for example, or we can trace a given system and record the address of each memory reference. The latter choice produces a large number of data. To reduce the number of data, we can use two facts. First, for a given page size, we need to consider only the page number rather than the entire address. Second, if we have a reference to page B, then any reference to this page that immediately follow will never cause a page fault since we have this page in memory. This page will be in memory after the first reference, so the immediately following references will not fault. For example, if we have the following address sequence at 100 bytes per page, this sequence is reduced to the following reference string: page 1, page 4, page 1, page 6, page 1, again page 1, and next we have page 1 three times, page 6, page 1, all these references, page 6, again page 1, next page 6 here, and again page 1. In counting the number of page faults for each page replacement algorithm, we will use only the reference string. In the next meeting, we'll discuss the different page replacement algorithms. For today, that's all. Thank you.